Welcome back to TECHMIMIC, where you can simply view, imitate, replicate, and get on with your day. If there is a specific issue for which you would like to see a video, please leave a comment. In this video, I'm going to show to you how to configure your Tapo device and VLC Media Player to watch the livestream of your camera. I've tested the instructions in this video on a couple of Tapo devices, including C310, C100, and C210. In my understanding, pretty much all Tapo cameras with a power connection will support live streaming. Devices with a battery, like the D230 doorbell camera, don't, as it would drain the battery in a very short period of time. At least to me, it appeared that way. During this video, I am using a Tapo C210 indoor pan and tilt camera, updated to the latest firmware and with the initial setup done. The camera is connected to my home Wi-Fi network and is visible in the Tapo app, where I can watch the live stream. We will need the IP address of the camera. In case you don't already know the IP address, you can check the device in the Tapo app. In this case, it is 192.168.178.7.1. I will demonstrate how to configure this first, and after that, I will provide a couple of suggestions why this might fail in your situation. For security purposes, we need to set up an account on the camera so that authentication is required when we access the video stream. Without this account, the video stream won't be exposed, and as such, it can't be used in the VLC Media Player. Click Settings. Click Advanced Settings. Camera Account. Create Now. Understand and Agree. Specify a username and password to be used for remote viewing of the camera. Click Create. To watch the live stream in VLC Media Player, open VLC Media Player. Click Open Network Stream. Here we can enter the URL to the camera. Let's start simple by just entering rtsp://192.168.178.71/stream1. Obviously, replace the IP address with your IP address. In this way, we will be prompted to enter the username and password interactively. RTSP means real-time streaming protocol, and that's what we need to use. Every Tapo camera has two streams. We will get back to this in a minute. Click play, specify the username and password, and now you might need to wait 10 to 20 seconds for the stream to start. Now that this works, you might want to specify the credentials in the URL itself, so that you don't need to type them every time. Change the URL to rtsp://username:\password@the IP address/stream2. You can use stream 1, but as I mentioned before, there are two streams, so let's change stream 1 to stream 2 to test that. It works. Most likely the video quality of stream 2 is less compared to what you saw before with stream 1. This is by design. Stream 2 is a lower quality and can be used for recording purposes to save some space. Stream 1 is a higher quality, better suited for live viewing of the live stream. To check the current quality of the stream, in VLC Media Player, click Tools and Codec Information. Stream 2 that we are watching now is 640 by 360 at 15 frames per second. The quality of Stream 1 is noticeably better with 1920 by 1080 at 15 frames per second. The quality of Stream 1 is determined by the video quality settings in the Tapo app. To improve your live viewing experience, open the Tapo app and do the following. Click Settings, Video and Display, Video Quality, and change the resolution. In this case, I will test with 2K. When we test Stream 1 again in VLC and check the properties, it is now indeed visibly better, and the codec information reads that we are streaming at 2K at 15 frames per second. If you want to see the stream statistics, for example the bitrate and the data sizes, you can click the Statistics tab. This should work within your own internal Wi-Fi network. The actual port that is being used for both streams is port 554. Let me demonstrate that by adding the port number to the URL. If the port is omitted, 554 is used by default. If you want to watch the video stream from outside of your network, when away from home, you can of course just use the Tapo app. But if you want to use VLC, you would need to configure some form of TCP port forwarding on your router, and also you would need to shoot a hole in your firewall for port 554. If you do that, keep in mind that the password you have specified earlier in the Tapo app needs to be a proper and complex password. If this does still fail, just a couple of suggestions. In this example, the Tapo cloud is not set up, and there is also no local memory card in the camera. The camera is not recording in any way, and the livestream in the app is all that we have. It appears that the Tapo camera can only support three streams to be configured at the same time. For example, one stream is the Tapo app itself, one for the local memory, and one for VLC Media Player will work because there is three in total. But when you configure the local app and the memory card and cloud recording in the Tapo cloud, there is already three streams, and the fourth stream to the VLC Media Player won't work. One of my test cameras wasn't exposing its external stream to VLC, and by simply removing one of the other streams, in this case the memory card, it worked instantly. Also, if there is no sound or very soft when you watch the live stream, simply adjust the camera microphone settings in the Tapo app. That's it. Hope it helped. And if it did, please like the video and keep it up. Until next time. Bye.